Dear students, let us continue program number 7. So here we are discussing about round robin. So in which some variable we have defined, and we are in the while loop 1. So we will use a for loop with I equal to 0, count equal to 0, comma I less than number of process n and I plus plus. So temp one we will initialize with time quantum. Where time quantum is what? Here time quantum it will be given here. As you can see in the diagram, time slice is nothing but time quantum. So here time quantum is defined in the main function, you can see that. Now if st of I means a service time which is equal to burst time of I equal to 0, that means service time of process equal to 0, then what we will do, we will simply increment the count value will be incremented, because that process doesn't need the service time, and we will continue the for loop. We will continue the for while loop. We are there in the under while loop. No, we are there just in the for loop. Again, count will be incremented, and temp one equal to again time quantum, and I will be incremented. I will be 1. So if service time of 1 equal to 0, then again count will be incremented and for loop will be continued. But if service time of any process is not equal to 0, then what will happen is will come here. If service time is greater than time quantum, if service time is greater than time, means first time is greater than the time quantum, then what will happen? That process will get that time quantum time to use the resource. So in that time, the remaining service time will be equal to service time minus time quantum. If this condition is also not true, means service time is not greater than time quantum, that is service time, but service time is greater than 0, then service time will be assigned to temp 1 and service time for I will be equal to 0, and then sq is equal to service quantum, utilize temp 1 value to calculate turnaround time. So total turnaround time is equal to previous turnaround time plus temp 1. So turnaround time of I equal to sq. Now here next, if n it will be your processing for all the process, if n equal to count, if count has equal to number of process, then we will break the for loop and while loop, and loop will be terminated. Then let us come here, calculate the wait and turnaround time. How to calculate wait time and turnaround time for I equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. Wait time equal to turnaround time minus burst time of each process, and summation of wait time equal to swt plus wait time of each process, and summation of turnaround time equal to summation of turnaround time plus turnaround time of I. Total. Then average waiting time equal to summation of wait time divided by n, and average turnaround time equal to summation of turnaround time divided by n. And here we can display printed process number, burst time, wait time, and turnaround time. For I equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. And here these things are there to display the each process number, its burst time, waiting time, and turnaround time. We can display here. Now let us come to the SRTF. Here again, SRTF is also called. Let us go to the choice case 2. Case 2, if you are pressing here, if you are giving here enter, if you are giving here choice, where is the choice? Here. If you are entering the choice 2, then what will happen? Okay, choice 2 is shortest remaining time next. So printf, enter the number of process, scanner, percentage d, and percentage n. Here we have to enter the number of processes, as you can see it in the diagram, that three processes we have taken, P1, P2, and P3. So, 3, n value 3. Then we will call SRTF n. So, let us go to the SRTF shortest remaining time. First, SRTF, where it is? No, I didn't get here. Yes, here it is, SRTF. So here we'll define some variable I, j, k, time equal to 0, float time average, waiting time, turnaround average, and waiting average time. For I equal to 1, I less or equal to n, I plus plus. Then process I dot id means we have different process equal to I. Enter the arrival time for process percentage d. We should enter the arrival time for each process. So here first process scanner percentage d process I dot arrival will enter, then each process, then printf enter the burst time for process I, then scanner percent d and percent process I dot burst. Each process, how much its burst time is there, that value also need to be stored, and process I dot remaining equal to process I dot burst. So this value will be calculated under one for loop for all the process. Next, we have two for I equal to 1, I less or equal to n, I plus plus, j equal to I plus 1, j less than n, j plus plus. Here we will be checking which process has come first. If process I dot arrival is greater than process j dot arrival. If process I means 1 is greater than, then we can do the interchange shuffling process. You know how to change the process. Temp will become process I, and process I equal to process J, and process J equal to temp. Means process I will become process J. Then number equal to 0, J equal to 1, check process. Check process whether still any process is there or not. Here check process is written, one function is written here for the check process. Here check process with the integer value. Integer. It is a function to check process remaining time is 0 or not. For I equal to 1, I less or equal to s, I plus plus. If process I dot remaining time is not equal to 0, then return 1, else return 0. That value we can see it here. And check process, if check process of n equal to 1, then if process number plus 1 dot arrival equal to time, and while process number 1 number plus 1 dot arrival equal to time, then number will be incremented. If process of j dot remaining equal to 0, then process of j dot finish equal to time. And here j equal to next process. So these things will be calculated here. If process j dot remaining is not equal to